there was plagiarism in the reports of the University of Alabama to the National Science Foundation. In this video, I will show you one of the papers they plagiarized from me. These documents were released by NSF through a FOIA request. My PhD dissertation was on vanadium dioxide. We applied for NSF funding and we got it. The fund was for 3 years, and we had to submit 3 annual reports and 1 final report. The annual reports were submitted, but the final report is still overdue. This is a picture of a warning issued by NSF a few months ago. The date of this warning was June 2022. The first report was in 2016. The second report was in 2017. And the third report had some delays and was submitted in 2019. I will show you a paper in which I was a co-author, and they plagiarized that paper. What you see is the first page of that paper in the 2016 report. You see my name here. And this is the same paper in the 2017 report. As you see, I was still one of the authors of the paper. Now, let's look at that paper in the third report in 2019. As you see, my name was removed and it was replaced by another person's name, Dr. Tim Lowell. This was plagiarism. If Dr. Laverne contributed to this paper, why wasn't his name in the first report? Why wasn't his name in the second report? How they can remove somebody's name and replace it with another name? It was only in the third report in 2019 that they plagiarized this paper and replaced my name with Dr. Laverne's name. All of the experiments for this paper was done by the end of 2015. All of the data were analyzed. All of the graphs were plotted. And in early 2016, we wrote the paper. Look at this picture of our email communications in April 2016. You can pause the video and read it. There was no Dr. Laverne here. This was a research article. It was based on experimental research. When the experiments were finished, we couldn't change the data. And they didn't change the data. They just changed the name of the people who had done the research. During publication, minor edits are possible. Sometimes the references who peer review the article may suggest some edits. For instance, take a look at this picture. It was edited to be like this. It is the same thing, just the figure was reshaped and the description was adjusted. But the professors cannot juggle the name of the people who had done the research and replace the researcher's name with somebody else. The corresponding professor for this project was Dr. LeClair. And the professor who signed and submitted the NSF report was Dr. Gupta. So these two professors were responsible for this plagiarism. And this was not their first plagiarism. They had plagiarized a lot of papers from me and many other scholars. 2 years prior to this plagiarism, Vice President Carl Pinkert started an investigation into plagiarism, fabrication, and some other misconducts. That time, Provost Kevin Whitaker shut down the Pinkert investigation. Dr. Pinkert had to step down from vice presidency and later on he left the university. If the Pinkert investigation did not fail, this plagiarism could not take place. There is another misconduct in this paper. They lied about funding from the Department of Energy. In the first and second report, they only acknowledged the National Science Foundation. This is their acknowledgement in the 2016 report, and this is the same in the 2017 report. Several years after the conclusion of the project, they told they had used funding from the Department of Energy. It was a lie. I'm sure they did not use even one penny from the Department of Energy. We were doing this research. We did not use any of that money. We did not have such a funding in this project. If they used any money from the Department of Energy, where are the receipts? They cannot show a receipt for even $1 expenditure, because it doesn't exist. Further, if they had used such a fund, they had to acknowledge it in the 2016 and 2017 reports, which they didn't. The reason I filed a FOIA with NSF was to find out what they had done with the computer technology. They stole all of the samples in 2017. I wanted to know to which company they sold the technology. Now, having this FOIA release, they need to explain what was their relation with the Department of Energy. Was there a collaboration after they stole the samples? Did they send any of those samples to the research centers of the Department of Energy to be tested? And still, it wouldn't affect this paper. This paper was finished several years earlier. You can download the NSF reports of this paper through a link in the description box. They have the headings of the federal court. That is because NSF did not release the FOIA request, and I had to file a lawsuit to get these documents. Through this FOIA lawsuit, they released 549 pages of documents. All of them are public knowledge now, and we will review some of them in other videos. Thank you for your attention.